types of cancer. This student said, I'm confused about the types of cancer. I understand benign and malignant, but is there a way to know them by name? Well, actually, in some ways there is, but let's go over some of the main ones and see if we can't help you there. So, malignant. Now, you said you knew the difference between malignant and benign, so I'm not going to talk about that because they definitely are different. This is actually a picture of a malignant cancer, and you notice those little spidery legs, spindly things coming out. That is what malignancy does, is it is invasive and it reaches out. It doesn't stay in that little circular. The most common ones are the ones that you want to memorize. Now again, there's different types, but these are the ones for the different body systems. If it's a carcinoma, it's skin. If it's a sarcoma, that's bone, cartilage, fat, muscle, blood vessels, connective, or supportive tissue. So it'll be a specific, they'll say a body part, sarcoma, okay? Leukemia is always about blood, all right? And it affects the bone marrow. That's what we're dealing with there. So leukemia is blood. A lymphoma is cells of the immune system. So again, a lymphoma, now notice all of these are ending in oma. That's a heads up for malignancy. But lymphoma is the immune system. Central nervous system cancer, there isn't a fancy name for those per se, but that is when they're dealing with brain and spinal cord. Okay. Now, there was another little slide here. I couldn't help but put this on here because this is classic of example of what malignancy does. Here you have this nice little blood, these cells right here, and here's a cell here, but you've got all these mutant cells, and look how it reaches out and connects. So you've got this cell here, and here is a different type of cell, and this, whichever one reached out, it grabbed the other one. Just perfect example of malignancy. Now, benign. Benign, you notice these don't have those little fingers, but these are, you know, meaning that they just kind of go crazy. They just keep growing and growing and stuff. So the basic ones for benign, you have adenomas, and that's epithelial tissue or gland. You have fibromas, which is connective tissue. You know how you have fibroids? People talk about that. That's all connective tissue. And here we have fibromas. And then we have hemangiomas. That is blood vessel cells. You have lymphoma, which is the fat cells. Then you have meningiomas, membrane of the brain or spinal cord. You have myomas, which is muscle. And again, my is the root word for muscle. So see how that is easy to remember. You have neva, which is skin. If they have a nevus, you've heard of that. Neuromas is the nerves. So you have the nerve cells going crazy there. You have osteochondromas. That's all about the bones. You have papilliomas, epithelial tissue with finger-like fronds. This is really unique because they are shaped different, and they are recognizable by those finger-like prongs that are fronds that come off of them. Now, again, these are the main ones and the basic cell types, but there is a fantastic website that will help you. It's on cancer.org. Let's go show that real quick here. I think you'll be impressed. Look here. Every type of cancer that you could possibly think of, all right? And then you can click on that, adrenal cancer, And then what they're going to do is give you the full breakdown of that type of cancer. See? And then you can get more information from there. Very impressive, cancer.org. If you need to be real savvy with the different types of benign and malignant, by name, cancer.org is going to give that to you. They will distinguish the malignant and the benign, and they will give the names and as much education as you could possibly imagine on that website. By the most part, you can go by, here we go, think leukemia. That is a white blood cell, and it's blood-forming tissue is where that happens. So you can take root words, usually, and having the oma on the end is a heads up for the cancer, but not always does it go by the root word. Go to cancer.org. And you'll find more information. There are other websites like WebMD that are very helpful. For the most part, the main cancers, it will not take long for you to have them in your head. So advice is, besides just remembering them, having them memorized, is to go to those websites and have them bookmarked so you can access them quickly. Right, and you really should educate yourself as much as possible, because as a coder, you're going to come across this on a daily basis. So it's very good to have asked this question and increase your skills in this area to be able to code to the highest specificity. Right.